Hey guys, Ray J. I'm July 5th, 1:51. So toilets all clean. I didn't record that because it was kind of bad. My countertop isn't that bad, but to me it's bad. So we're going to clean that. I still have to clean the table in the living room, but as I was saying before I left for a smoke break, I usually do the bathroom before I go for a smoke break or after I come in from a smoke break. So, then that way I don't get bored from doing one thing. Like, I like to move around. Otherwise, like I said, I'm gonna fall asleep. That's what I like about being in the kitchen because when I'm in the kitchen, I'm cooking, I'm prepping, I'm cleaning, I'm doing everything, right? But because I'm always in the kitchen room with the new cat, I get nothing done. So today I'm focused on the washroom and whenever I get to 32 minutes, because it's just pretty much 2 o'clock now, I'm gonna call it a night. Like I'm gonna start warming up my food and what do you call it? Eat and get ready and go to bed. So, but I do wanna finish the bathroom. That's why I like recording cleaning, because then it encourages. I love watching people clean videos and cleaning videos, and it helps me to want to clean, so I hope it does the same for you. It also forces me to actually clean if I'm on camera, because then I'm like, well, now that I started it, I gotta finish it. Like I said, I could keep track of when I've done stuff. So I was trying to figure out when I vacuumed last. And then I went through all my videos, and that's how I know. So if you're like me and you have a bad memory, that's what I do this for. So I'm gonna clean the counter. I gotta move stuff, and then I gotta wipe it down, and then check on the time. I'm probably not gonna vacuum tonight, but at least the stuff underneath the table is moved. Because like I said, tomorrow I'm just going shopping, and then I'm gonna come back home. So I know what I'm doing is going downtown again and get vet food, so not too much. But yeah, so let's do this, and then I'm also gonna feed Bud half his food, because now I've been putting it all the way into the carrier and he's been going in to get used to it. So now you guys can actually see it because I didn't record it earlier. But yeah, let's start cleaning. No music because I don't want to keep moving the computer around, and this is going to be fast anyways. So, there'll be music on once we get into the living room. So, this is cleaning the counter, and actually, I think I'm going to move you guys here, because then you can see better. Right? And I'm pretty tired, so whenever I have my head up, that means I'm tired. So, we'll see how much I get done. So now I just kind of move everything off the counter like so. I put my cup far away so it doesn't get stuck on it. I mean in it. And then stuff here. Voila. Yeah, I got the paper towels here. Then I take the glass cleaner that I had done with, as always. I guess you guys can't really see me. There. So you can see what I'm doing at least. Spray down the mirror. Got the towel thing. Just a little bit, because then it makes it shiny. And then the spray. And I use a lot of spray, and then I do the bottom counters every time. Like so. And actually, I think I'll move you guys on the other side, because I don't edit my videos, so you guys know I try to. I move you guys around a lot so you can see the what I'm doing. And I know people are like, why are you always in the photos? I'm like, because when I see my friends post photos of their food that they make or what they cleaned, I'm like, what's the point of that? I want to see you in the photo too and in the video. I don't want to just see what you've done and that's it. I mean, anybody could have done it, so that's the way that I look at it, at least. So I always try to get myself in a shot. That's why, like, when I'm in the kitchen or if I'm in the table, I'm like bending down so you can kind of see what I'm doing. Just because people ask that a lot. And like, because I don't like it how my friends just show that they clean the washroom, but they're not in it. So it's like, what's the point to me? That's how I feel about it. Anyways, water's going to go on in a bit. Just have to do the... So the paper towels I only use for the toilet and the mirrors. And I've shown you guys how to do the toilet so many times. Remember, I used to work at Rogers Arena and the P&E as a washroom attendant and a bunch of golf events and stuff. So, even if it's just a little dirty, it drives me nuts because I think I still have that in my head. I'm like, I gotta clean it. So, at least that's how I feel about it. I just wipe it down once because I don't really care about streaks. It's just me. It's an old house. An old basement seat. My hair is kind of a mess now. And Bud's just laying down on the bed. So, at least when I'm in the bathroom, he's not distracting me. And I usually always wipe things down in 2 times because you never know. Always do it 2 times. Is it right too? Oops. And even though my kitchen is a mess, that's okay because I gotta focus on the bathroom and the living room. And then tomorrow I could work on the kitchen. Like I said, when I wake up, I wanna make tofu scramble. So I'll be doing the dishes and kitchen stuff then before I head out. Because it always takes me at least an hour to head out. I'm always cleaning. Cleaning and kicking, because I want to eat before I go out. So now water's going on. And I have to get new cloths anyways. Because these are pretty old. And whenever I use flour, it always gets dirty. So I throw them out, because it's very hard to clean. But I think I'm gonna buy a bunch today from the dollar store. So yeah, at least now I don't have to go to Walmart. I just use Instacart. If I have to, I go to No Frills. Cause now I gotta buy cat stuff. And then I use the lint rollers to get rid of the hair on the toilet and on the sink. Separate lint rollers. But basically I wipe it down once and I wait for it to dry and then that's when I do the lint rollers. But I'm probably going to do that tomorrow since I want to do the living room next. The rest of the table. But since Bud's been such a good boy, I am going to give him some food. There we go. That's good enough for now. Like I said, I'm gonna finish this off tomorrow to let this dry. And that's when I use a lint roller. Like I said, I live alone, so it doesn't matter that much. It's just that when there's lots of hair and yellow marks from the soap and stuff, then it annoys the heck out of me. That's why I try not to have too much stuff on here anymore. I use that instead, but I keep forgetting to move it back. So that's done. Yay, see how easy that is? And I just wipe this down like that. Just to get the dust. Oh yeah, I have to put it down the toilet paper roll. It's dusty. And I have one rag for cleaning stuff, and then I have one rag for dishes. And I wash them. Unless if they're really gross, then I throw them out. And then get new ones. Woohoo! Tastes so much better. My little head in the way. Look at that, it only took, what, 9 minutes to do? Doesn't take long. It's just that when I'm focused on one thing, then that's what I'm focused on, and that's why now I'm trying to go back and forth. Because I still have to clean this off, and then I'm going to have to sweep and mop, but I'm going to do that tomorrow. So, lots of cleaning this weekend. Lots of cleaning this weekend. So yeah, look how messy my kitchen is. But you know what? It's always going to be messy. That's just the way that I look at it. And like when I'm in the kitchen, that's when I clean the kitchen. When I'm in, when the bathroom annoys the heck out of me, that's when I do the bathroom. When the living room annoys me, that's when I do the living room. Yeah, it's kind of cold now. 2 o'clock. I'm gonna grab some water too. And everything that's in the sink right now is all just cans pretty much. So I'm just letting them soak. So then it's easier to wash and take the paper out and put it in recycling. And now. I didn't put Bud's container back. I'm gonna have to use permanent markers, I guess, for it. I have them somewhere. Truth be told, I don't think it really matters if you use a cat thing and a human thing, like, as long as you wash it really well. Like, I put cat food in the container and I end up using it for mine as long as I wash my dishes really good, so it should be fine. Oh, and I'm gonna use chia seeds. I'm about to do that when I came home, so I find that when I use chia seeds every day with water, it helps a lot. I don't go to the washroom as much. I never knew you could drink it, so I just put a little bit in. Chia seeds. I have so many chia seeds. I usually put it in salads. Oh yeah, I'm gonna make salad. Oh well. I'll use tomorrow. That's what I cut up the cucumbers for the other day. And then I completely haven't had the time. So like today I really don't want to go out, but I have to get cat food. And more pet food. And they have eggplant on sale in a package for $1.50. So I'm only giving half. And I'm gonna give half in the morning when I wake up. And grab more cans. So it my bake's slow, so I'm probably not gonna get my GST till later. That's fine. I know it's gonna be some kind of money. Well, actually, I'm not gonna use the container, so I'm just gonna put these here for now. But just because it's. I'm only using half the can, so it seems like a waste. I'm just gonna put the can the lid back on. There comes bed. That's all I need, bud, because I don't have any more food. Meow. 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 Want a good boy? You'll be coming around the mountain, which she comes. I think we have just enough time to clean the table. Because I don't want to be up too late. So, this is what I've been doing. Oops. Yeah. I'm also going to open up the top of the cat carrier and start putting toys in here for him to play. Because, like I said, I've been watching a lot of videos how to get your cat in the carrier. Because I forget easily. Bad. Here you go. He's a little hesitant at first, but see, he goes all the way in. Although he sticks his butt out. But I didn't put it all the way back. So that, my friends, is the slow way. I also saw a video of somebody saying you could put them in a pillowcase. I'm like, putting by folding it and putting it over the cat and then flipping it. And I'm like, I would not even try that with Bud. No way. His nails are like really long. And yeah, that method, I think that method only works with cats. I know you could do the towel thing too, but yeah, no. I'd rather take Bud to the vet when I could actually hold him, or like just hold him like this without him trying to attack me. So then that way, in case they ask me to hold him, then I can. So, but yeah, I don't know if anybody's heard of that before, but I've never heard of that. Put a pillowcase over them and put them in and put in the carrier, and then they get loose though when they're in the cat carrier, so it's not like they're not breathing. But yeah, this thing looks like it's the top of the screw. I don't know if I could get it off. I don't think it comes off. Pretty bad. Yeah, it does. I don't. Oh, maybe if I did it to every single one. Let's see. No, this is gonna scare Bud. Oh, sorry, Bud. Oh man. two more. Ow. Okay, I'm not gonna bother. Okay, there you go, bud. Sheets? No, they're in the back. That's bad. Is that it? Is now he's too scared. There you go. I pushed it further back. I can't figure out the screws. They hurt. They kind of hurt. So while he eats, we're going to finish off the stable. So the stuff that I had earlier, I just brought it to the front and where it had to go. But I forgot the cup. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I'll do that. Maybe I'll stay up later. We'll see. I kind of want to get this done. So, we'll put the music on and then I'm kind of awake now. Well, I'm going to do it until I get hungry. So, I guess for now, I'll put you guys. I forgot the box that's in the bathroom. Did you eat all your food? Sorry, my mind's kind of awake, but not really awake, so I forgot that I should put the music on. So I'm gonna put the music on now, and we'll finish this table. This bed. This is where he usually hides. So this is why he's like, what happened to everything? So yeah, I'm gonna put the music on. I'm gonna try to finish this table tonight. And we'll see. I mean, I'm tired, but I'm not tired, so I'm gonna put the music back on.
Time.
Actually, before it gets too late, I'm gonna vacuum. Just where the table is. And then I'll go again.
There was a moment there where I really thought it was gonna pass out. Ready? Alright, I'd like to introduce you guys to Tariq Hoftaev. Is a 12-year-old girl who lives in Coffee Village with her mother, father, three sisters, and brother. Tariq is the oldest child in her family, and because of that, she spends a lot of her time helping out at home. Even though she loves attending school more than anything else, before she can do that, she has to finish her chores, which start the same way every morning with walking to collect dirty water. I asked Tariq if I could go collect water with her because it's something I have never experienced myself. We talk about it a lot at Charity Water. Women in Ethiopia in particular spend hours every day walking to find and collect water. I know that, but now it's time for me to see what that's like.
Rush hour traffic on the morning commute.
Tariq's family lives on the very top of a hill, and though it only takes about 30 minutes to reach the bottom, when you factor in 90-degree heat and the 7,000-foot elevation, none of it is easy. This trickle of a stream is where 1,825 people come to collect their water. Tariq and I fill our jerry cans with 40 pounds of water and prepare to head back up to her house on the hill.
Yeah. now.